let's have a look now the benefit of implementing the DHP. So implementing the DHP is a key way to facilitate the standard and the interoperability. So this is the two main objective and the two main benefits, because we can in some way standardize all the software, all the way how we collect the data, but at the same time can be interoperatively. It means that it can cooperate in some way with any sort of difference appliance connected with the healthcare system. DHP also enhance and accelerate the development of the digital health services and application as part of wider national and e-health strategy, and also simplify the information exchange within the health sector. This is another very important aspect, as we already see. It's very important that the information in some way can be shared between and among all the actors of the healthcare sector. And also the platform allows a user of an external application system, such as health consumer using an app and mobile devices, to access information gathered by the digital health software without requiring those tools to integrate directly with one another or even be aware of one another. And also by providing the foundation of common component to the digital health application and system, the platform accelerate the development of a new software as well as rollout of improvement to existing software. So as soon as we already implement this digital healthcare platform, we don't need to create several different software. We can create a software that can be interconnected with the entire and with a common platform. So the support to the wider health sector in improving is the following. So this is all the benefit that we can achieve implementing a common platform, a common digital platform. First of all, there is the overall quality and continuum of care. We can adherence to clinical guideline and best practice, efficiency and affordability of services and health commodity by reducing duplication of effort and ensuring effective use of time resources. From the economic point of view, this can really cut the cost from the spending, especially from the public health spending point of view, because we can avoid to create different sources of information. All the software that are interconnected with the platform can be and using the same technology and the same can use the same data. Also, the regulation, they were said, the patient safety resulting from an increasing availability of performance. Of course, this also create a benefit for the patient, because as soon as we have one common platform, any sort of patient, they can access to this platform directly. Meanwhile, at the moment, there are maybe some clinical or some hospital where you can get access. But generally, as soon as you're not in the position as the entire public health is digitalized, sometimes the patient can have not the access to the entire healthcare system. So maybe he can communicate using the smartphone, using with some app, maybe with some clinical, some private clinical to have back the examination, to contact the doctors and so on. But this, as soon as it's not implemented a platform at national level, he cannot connect to the entire public healthcare systems. Also, data and reduction errors can be improved, and also help policy making and resource allocation based on better quality data. So we will see that there are several benefits. We will see also how there is a lot of barrier and a lot of problem to implement at national level. As soon as we can reach these goals, this is represent an incredible opportunity for all the actors of the healthcare system, as soon as by the patient. I show you here one example from Canada, where they develop a common platform that is called the Electronic Health Record Solution Blueprint. So basically, the Canada Health InfoWay, if you remember already, we already talking about the Canada Health InfoWay as a case study, conceptualize an architecture for implementing large-scale national AHR solution, resulting in architectures called the AHR's blueprint. So the blueprint is an early example of the digital health platform. The blueprint offers an information system architecture describing how each point of services application can connect to the shared infrastructure information through an interoperability layer called the Health Information Access Layer. And using agreed upon standard facility, this connection and interoperability. So the design approach taken is for each Canadian jurisdiction, so we're talking about province or territory or municipality, to implement an operation information infrastructure. This infrastructure allows a large number of a variety of point of services software system to either capture or assess clinical and administrative information about citizens and the health services provided to them. This is a typical case where a country was able to implement a digital platform at national level. And this is create so many benefits, not just for the access to the data, but also to the interconnectivity between the province, the territory, the small city, the small town, or the municipality, and all the software they are connected in terms of services, in terms of medical examination, and so on, can have the access to a single unique platform where all the government can also share any sort of information and contact directly also the patient. This is how the Canadian Health Work Health InfoWay works. This is represented the development of electronic health record solution. So you see how there is, for example, up in the info structure, there is ancillary data and services, health information data warehouse, data and services, registered data and services, for example, all the payment that is registered, all the medical examination that is registered inside the platform. Then we have created a longitudinal record services, and then we have an health information access layer. This gives the possibility to interact with any sort of different department of the healthcare systems. Then where is above there is what is called the point of services application. Point of service application could be, for example, a private clinical that specializes in RX or in any sort of services. Could be also an external or stakeholders, for example, in terms of insurance, AHR viewers. So there are different stakeholders that can access directly into this platform. At the same time, they also can gain information from the entire platform. Here I want to show you a visual summary of the digital health the DHP development stage, key question and deliverables. That's to, just to understand how is the structure of the platform. So generally we have the digital health system building stage, so the strategy development, the digital health intervention, identification and requirement of analysis, digital health platform design, and then at the end we implement and the maintenance and scale up of the platform. There are of course some key questions when we're thinking and when we are at the stage of implementing and developing a digital platform in healthcare. So for example, one of the main questions could be, what change do we want in order to strengthen the health system? So what are the main problems that represent our healthcare systems? For example, what could be a very long waiting list for some specific medical examination, or could be the way how it's become difficult the payment for the patient to straight, or maybe the reimbursement. So there are several questions that we can address before implementing a digital platform. So for example, which digital health intervention are needed to improve existing business process to meet health outcomes? Or which existing application need we do modify? How should we redesign existing process? Then we can see how should we modify the existing application. For example, how we can adapt the app that we have on our mobile to communicate and how can be this internet connectivity relationship between the platform and any sort of app. And at the end we see how do we implement a digital health information infrastructure and how we can ensure a sustainable scale up later on. So there are different steps. This is the typical process when we develop a digital platform. Then there is the deliverables in terms of health system outcomes, so mapping the existing health system intervention. So there are different stages. And this is a represent this slide that I want to just to show you to understand how is the process to develop a digital platform, but at the same time to be really effective it's very important that at the beginning we start to realize and we have to ask to all the stakeholders, so to all the people that work inside the healthcare, which is the main problem, how we can solve this problem, and especially with the digitality, how we can improve the services, because with the digital devices we can cut the costs in terms of time in spending, in collecting the information, in providing maybe a waiting list to the patient, how we can improve the relationship between the employer that work inside the healthcare. So this is a typical way, and it's very important that you focus in a different steps how we can implement the platform, but not just from the technical point of view, from the conceptual point of view, to understand which is the quick questions and how we can really sustain in the outcomes in these public services. Then we have different types of business process in healthcare. So we have the facility-based patient care services. We have, of course, the communication. We have the remote patient care services, such as the telemedicine, personal health tracking, health education. We have the health sector resource management and regulation, individual identify management and records, financial and insurance management, data management and processing. So this is represent different business processes in the health systems. And of course, the digitalization can improve can improve the efficiency, especially when all these kind of different business, even if it's a separate, but in some way they need a common platform to share the same data and also communicate between one business to another one. For example, it's extremely important that remote patient care services communicate with, for example, with the facility-based patient care services, the laboratory, the diagnostic. So this is very important that also the design of this platform is implemented, taking in consideration the different business in the healthcare. There is also another example how high priority health system business process and digital health intervention can be implemented. So also this, from the digital point of view, can be constructed in this way. So we have the national health strategy that represents the government health strategy with all the objectives, with all the fundings and all the correlating spending review. So this is represent the general strategy. Then we have different health outcomes. For example, support more informed policy and investment decision through access to timely and accurate and comprehensive information. Another, for example, outcomes could be enable healthcare access to patients in remote communities. Another different e-health outcomes could be improved quality, safety, and efficiency of clinical practice by giving health workers better access to patient information, clinical evidence, and decision support. Then we have all the different business processes. For example, population health surveillance. We can have the alert public authority about disease and incidents. So there are different sub structured outcomes. Anyway, this is the how we can prioritize in some way the objective, starting from the general one, from the national health strategy, to different sub outcomes. And in some way you can imagine how the connection from the data point of view, how is important, and how is important that different business process can interact each other. So the transition into the healthcare represents a revolution in terms of increasing the speed of a communication, increasing the quality, and also increasing the amount of data that we can share between one business department and another one inside the healthcare systems. This is the typical forum question that you will read later the lecture. So let's summarize this last lecture. So we see how taking an holistic approach to digital health system building can impact care delivery and health system operation. So it's very important, also the last slide that I show you, that we create a digital platform, for example, but that have an holistic view. It means that should include any sort of sector of the public, any sort of business that operate inside the inside the healthcare. And also by focusing on interoperability amongst all the digital health application used by the patient and facility alike, information exchange can be improved across your system. And also the digital platform facilitate this interoperability, enabling application to exchange information even though they are not directly integrated. Another important point is the fact that this information exchange is standardized. This is a problem that in most of the country, also in European country, they are not standardized the information. It means that some information, only some business part of the healthcare can have the access, but not the entire healthcare systems. So it's very important to standardize the information to create a platform, a uniform platform, a unique platform from the government point of view, and it's also is extremely important that any sort of software, any sort of digital device that we connect and that we use in the healthcare should be connected and should be interconnected to share the information. Thank you very much for your kind attention.